What is the area of the squared? Well, let's give it a try. So this is how I will go about solving this. First, we want the area of the square, and this right here is labeled it to be a already, and that's a square, so we can just come here in the middle and say that's also a. And then next, let's go ahead and put down the center of the circle. Let's say somewhere right here. And we can also label the radius from here to here. Let's call that to be r. Likewise, we also know from here to here will be r as well. In fact, we can come with an equation relating r and a already, because the whole thing here is the diameter, which is 2r. And that's actually equal to, you see, from here to here is a, and then from here to here is 1. So we must have 2r equals a plus 1. Yay, first equation. Now, what do we do next though? Well, let's do the usual trick when we're doing geometry. Let's just connect stuff. So maybe let's go ahead and connect the center to the corner of the square right here. And that's also the radius, that's nice. And maybe we can also go horizontally too. But what's this though? This right here, remember, this part is a, and this is just half of it, so that's a over 2. Yay, and that's a right triangle. And do we know this side right here? In fact, we do, because from here to here, it's the radius, and then from here to here is 1. Therefore, this side has to be r minus 1. And because we have a right triangle, so we can use the Pythagorean theorem and set an equation, which gives us r squared equals, and let's write down a over 2, this side, squared, and then we add the other side, r minus 1 squared. And then let's just work this out. So we get r squared equals a over 2 squared is a squared over 4 plus r minus 1 squared. Expand that, we get r squared minus 2r plus 1. And then let's just go ahead and minus 2 r squared on both sides. So they cancel. And that looks really nice. In the meantime, I'm also going to add 2r on both sides. You will see why right now. Because on the left-hand side, we have 2r, and that's equal to a squared over 4, and then we have that plus 1 right here. And then, by the way, this and that will cancel it already. And this is actually super nice, because if you look at the first equation, we have 2r equals a plus 1, and the second equation, we have 2r equals a squared over 4 plus 1. So, we can just say a plus 1 has to be equal to a squared over 4 and then plus 1. So combining these two equations, we have a plus 1 equals a squared over 4 and then plus 1. And we just have to solve for a and then multiply by itself. Then we get the area of the squared. All right, so from here, of course, we can just minus 1 on both sides. And then we are getting a equals a squared over 4, then multiply both sides by 4, so this and that cancel, and we get 4a equals a squared. This is a quadratic equation, so that's minus 4a on both sides, because we want to make one side equal to 0. So when we do that, we get 0 equals a squared minus 4a. And then can we factor the right hand side? Yes, we can factor on a. So 0 equals a times a minus 4. So this means a equals 0 or a minus 4 equals 0. But a equals 0 is not possible because this is a geometry question. We actually have that square, right? So the only choice is a minus 4 equals 0. And we add 4 on both sides and get a equals 4. So finally, we know that squared, each side is a, so a is equal to 4, a is equal to 4, and the area is just 4 times 4, or 4 squared, and that's just equal to 16. So that will do it. That's it.